As we learn new topics and include examples one by one, we can see our page is getting filled up. When contents of a component grows, it has to be broken down into smaller components. For example, let us consider a website that has a header, sidebar, and main content. Each section can be divided into a separate component. But these components cannot be left independent to each other. It has to be brought together under a common parent component, and all the other components will become child components. The main content component can be further divided into two child components. This is what is called as component hierarchy. Let us now see how components are going to be organized in our ng-learn application. In the ng-learn application, we have app component, which will be the parent-most component. In this component, we have coding implemented in app.component.html and app.component.ts. We are going to create a new component named Getting Started Component, and this will contain all the features that we have implemented so far. This new component will be a child component of app component with its own HTML template and TypeScript class. Whatever coding that we have done so far will be moved to the new component so that the contents of this Angular application gets into the respective child component. We will subsequently create new components one by one based on new topics that we will learn in Angular. Hope this gives an high-level view on how components in our ng-learn application is going to be organized. From the next video onwards, we will start to create the getting started component.